What's up, guys? It's Steve. I'm back, and today we're gonna be working on the IT200. I know it's been a while since I worked on the bike. The last video was about the levers, and then the video before that was about my screw up with the reed valve. But I think I finally got the right one. So to start off, let me show you the stock, okay? And I'm gonna show you the one that I got, Moto Tassanari V3, courtesy of Jeff. He really helped me out. I sent him the dimensions of the stock one, and he sent me this. So the part number for this one is V3145. Now, shout out to Jeff over at Moto Tassanari who helped me out. What I did was I sent him a picture with a vernier caliper measuring the distance from here to here, from here to here, from here to here, and from this bolt to that bolt. So let me show you real quick the similarities. Now the stock looks a lot bigger, but I'm pretty sure we're gonna get more airflow with the V3. Aside from that, to accompany the reed valve, we got this bad boy right here from Lectron. I think it's wider than stock, but hopefully it doesn't give me too much issues. It's cold and it's gonna be a little hard to bend the boot, but if I have any trouble, I'll just grab the heat gun and I'll heat it up. And last but not least, the big boy, DG Fatty Pipe. Super, super excited to have this thing. Okay, so I just dropped the bolt in there. I went to my work truck and I picked up this magnet. I'm gonna see if I can get it out. Oh my god. Oh dude, it went right in the cylinder. All right, back to the regularly scheduled programming. Okay, so here we got the reed. I'm going to just show you what fitment is like with stock. With the aftermarket, it should be nice and simple. Nice. Awesome. So I'm about to just rip off this old gasket. Alright, so two things real quick. I thought I was recording, but I wasn't. You got these flaps on the stock boot. You want to cut them off, right? Because they used to fit on the original reed, but on the aftermarket reed, they're not going to fit. So you want to take them off so this will sit flush. Now, anybody who's ever owned one of these, yes, you can pull this out. Okay, but I actually asked about that for my other bike. I asked Jeff from Moto Tassanari, you know, if it was worth taking it out. What are the benefits? What are the pros? What are the cons? So this right here, this piece, it's gonna make sure that you have bottom end torque when you're riding, which is important for the trails. So for my purposes, I'm gonna keep this. Also, it regulates air velocity. So basically, keep this in. Don't take this out. I spoke to a couple of guys before about this that, you know, they installed it, they took it out, but I'm going to trust the pros. I'm going to leave this piece in. I recommend you do it as well. So over here, I got my little mini Dremel. I just want to install the sander and hit the boot just to make sure that everything's flush. Thank you. I got a little wire brush for this also, so I'm just gonna make sure that the old gasket is completely gone too. I decided to go a different approach. I'm gonna install the boot with the carb at the same time, but before, I'm just gonna grind these out. You don't really need them anymore with the Lectron. Alright, so we're gonna slap this on. Went on nice and easy. Now let's put the bolts back. All right, so now that the carburetor's installed, I'm just gonna briefly take out the exhaust so I can install the new one. So off the back, I already know there's an issue. The mounting bracket on the exhaust, I'm gonna need a nut and bolt, and I don't really know if I have that right now. I gotta look for it. Hopefully I can find something that'll work. I'm just loosening up this grommet, and I went over to my work truck and I grabbed these picks so I can pull back on the springs. I missed recording this too, but whatever, I got the exhaust pipe out. So let me just install the new one real quick. Carburetor on, I'm just gonna install the tank. That way I can test it out, see if the bike even turns on. So one thing about Lectron, before you order the carburetor, they ask you what modifications you have, what kind of riding you're gonna do, the altitude. So I told them I'm gonna be doing trails. I told them that I got the reed and the exhaust. So that's what the carb is tuned for. So anyway, the bolt wasn't flowing. So I went on Lectron website to see what could the problem be. And they said just tap it. So I tapped it, now it flowed. But I missed the video, so whatever, it's all good. All right, so I tried kickstarting it, nothing. As of right now, I adjusted the idle screw, and now it kind of turns off, but it falls flat on its face. It's probably running lean. I looked at the instructions, and basically I have to adjust one of the jets. So I'm just going to show you where I'm up to right now. It's kind of late, so I'm going to get back to work tomorrow. what's up? So, I changed my mind. I am not gonna continue this video with me tuning the carb and turning it on. I'm gonna make that a completely separate video on how to tune the Lectron carb. I'm gonna go and do it as I learn. That's the only way I do learn. But at least I know for a fact that my bike is running. I did turn it on. And that was the objective for today. The rest of the mods, like the foot pegs, and I think that was it. I'm gonna take care of that later. I'm also gonna do a video on the suspension. I'm gonna get the suspension done. So that's it. We're gonna watch the fight tonight. You'll probably see this video after McGregor either wins or loses. Let me know what you think about the fight. Let me know what you think about my build. And if you have any questions, just leave them in the comments. See you later.